GramGreene.
It is your boy GramGreene, and we are back with another GramGreene GramCam extended edit. And this one is one of my favorite stories of 2019. Towards the end of it, December, where I played Space Yacht back to back, my sobrino SUELDO, an amazing GramGreene story, and I am so hyped to bring it to you guys and explain what exactly happened. Before moving forward, my name is GramGreene. I'm a videographer, vlogger, DJ, and aspiring producer, bringing you the most lit and epic content from the underground riddim and dubstep scene. I've been doing it since 2015, and since then, I've taken up my own journey going through this crazy world of DJing and producing and bringing you guys along for the ride. Welcome back, guys. I hope you've been enjoying whatever the fuck I've been uploading recently, and I know it's been fire, because I always got the fire, the flames, no liar. Jay! I gotta get out more. We're going back to December 18th, actually, to be exact, where I make it to Las Vegas. How do I make it to Las Vegas? How do I end up playing Space Yacht again? Well, I got booked to an Earthquake Weather show going back to back with Rampage, with all the Dons. As I was buying my flights for LA, I saw that there was an option to fly from Philadelphia to Los Angeles. I would get to Los Angeles on the 19th, but there's a layover in Las Vegas. The flight was only $92 one way, so I was like, dude, I can't pass this up. So I look further into it, and the layover in Las Vegas was 10 hours. Ugh. It was also on a Wednesday, so it's kind of like middle of the week. I'm not really sure what's happening in Las Vegas that day, but I'm like, whatever, fuck it. I'd fly from Philadelphia at around like 6, 7 p.m., make it to Las Vegas like around 10:30, and then I would have up until 9 a.m. till my next flight to Los Angeles. So I'm like, all right, cool, Las Vegas. Probably always a lot of things to do at night. I could either, you know, go to a techno club, or I could go gambling, or I can meet up with some friends. There's a lot of things I could do. So I was like, fuck it, we're gonna do it. 10 hour layover, GramGreene. So a week before I'm supposed to fly out to Las Vegas, I get some information that there's a show happening the Wednesday that I actually fly in. I'm like, great. Further info, looked into it, hit up my connects, and find out that my sobrino, SUELDO, is actually playing. SUELDO is someone that I met in 2017 in LA, and he's been a mega supporter of mine. I had the honor of putting him on my stage for the Savage Society 5th year takeover last year, and ever since then, I've been seeing him progress, not only as a producer, but as a DJ, and also as a human being, and he's such a genuinely nice person. I'm always very happy to see him. So I hear that he's playing in Las Vegas. I'm like, excellent, I'm gonna hit him up. I text him and I let him know that I have a 10-hour layover in Las Vegas, the date of his show. I ask him what time he plays. He says he plays 10 p.m. And I'm like, oh shit, I get in at 10:30, so I might be able to catch the end of your set. And he's like, for sure, Theo, let's definitely hang out. And I'm like, excellent, cannot wait to see you. Couple hours later, I find out that Al Ross, Yax, and Algo are all playing this show. Whoa, even better. This is gonna be a great night. I fly in, get to chill with the homies. It's going to be amazing, I cannot wait. A few minutes after that, Jello, aka SUELDO, hits me up and he's like, hey bro, like, would you be down to go back to back with me? I'm like, yeah bro, but like, I wouldn't make it there on time, blah blah blah. I'm like, hey, by the way, what show is this? I didn't even bother to ask what show it was once I just knew the homies were gonna be there. So I'm like, whatever show it is, it's cool. My friends are gonna be there. I then find out that it's Space Yacht. Space Yacht. I love Space Yacht. If you guys have been following this channel, I've actually played a couple Space Yachts. One in Houston, another one in LA, and then I would be attending this one in Las Vegas. I'm like, great, love the Space Yacht people. I love what they do. They're ahead of the curve, and they've inspired me a lot to really do what I'm doing currently in my life. I let Jello know, like, dude, I'm super down to go back to back with you. Just let me know the details, yada, yada, yada. A couple minutes later, my brother, Diego, who has been a mega supporter of mine since 2018, he booked me out to my first Earthquake Weather show back in June of 2018. Let's go! One of the most monumental shows I've had in the West Coast, really put my name on the map out there. And ever since then, he's been supporting me, always trying to put GramGreene out there, and I've been doing that vice versa for him, for not only Earthquake Weather, but also for Space Yacht. So he hits me up, he works for Space Yacht, and he's like, bro, let's put you on the lineup, I'm about it. I'm only supposed to be here for a layover, so dude, let's get this going. We got it going. Couple minutes later, we have the flyer out, we announce it, and bam, your boy landed a booking by having a layover in Las Vegas.
Great.
I started off in Northern Jersey. I have to catch my bus like around 2:30 to go to Philadelphia to make it there like around 4:30. And then from there, go to the airport, catch my flight like at 6:30, right? Should be easy enough. But I had this this job that I was working at on the side, and I couldn't get out on time, so I needed to take an Uber from my house to New York to catch the bus to go to Philadelphia, from there to catch a flight to go to Las Vegas. We made it in time, thankfully. I thought I wasn't going to, but whew, yes, we made it. I was very afraid there would be delays of the flight, maybe weather or whatnot, but everything went smoothly, perfectly, and I made it there without a hitch. Met up with my two queens, Elise and Zeta, who took care of me. I love you girls, thank you so much. They have been mega supporters of GramGreene for a very long time as well, so it was very nice to meet with them. Brought me to the club, and I was able to catch a little bit of Algo, the Al Ross back-to-back Yak set. It was just a straight homie fest, and towards the end, that's when I would go back-to-back with SUELDO. So, here we go. I hope you guys enjoyed this edit. Don't forget to do that thing, like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know what you think of this video, and, hello, I hope this is recording. It's your boy GramGreene here. It's very stressed at the moment. Now my bus leaves to Philadelphia to go to Vegas in approximately an hour and 30 minutes. There's a lot of traffic on the way home, so I don't know if I'm gonna make it. I gotta make a decision real quick. Yeah, keep it locked. We'll see what happens. I love you guys. Enjoy these last two shows. Chee! Hello guys. Yeah, so I'm still stuck in traffic. This is classic, classic GramGreene travels. Yeah, so pretty much my plan was get to the bus stop to go to Philadelphia where my flight's leaving at 7:45, get there, public transportation. But for some reason today, they decide to have all the traffic in the fucking world. Like all of it, all of the world. So that plan is botched. I cannot take public transportation anymore because my bus leaves in a little over an hour and it's just logistically not gonna work out. So we gotta reorganize. I'm always organizing in my head, always. You know, fucking hell. Jesus Lord, just let me go. Once we get to the city, we take the bus to Philadelphia, we take our flight to go to Vegas, then we have a 10-hour layover, we play Space Yacht, we get on a flight, 9 in the morning, fly out to LA, bool out for a day, and the next day play a show with Rampage and all the Dons. Then that's it, that's 2019 in a nutshell. Ending it very strong. Obviously, there's gonna be anxiety getting there because, you know, nothing ever works out to plan, but I always have a structure. It's okay if things don't work out because a backup plan. So what I'm gonna do, drop off my car at my house and just get a lift. Fuck it. Like, that's literally the only option that I have if I wanna catch my bus and make it to the airport on time. Because if I catch the later bus, there's a possibility that that's already sold out. They're not gonna let me get on the bus, so that wouldn't be fun. Oi, it is your boy, GramGreene. We made it. I took a lift thinking that I would make it to my bus on time, but I did not. Missed it by 2 minutes, classic. So I waited for the other one, but we should be okay. Flight looks okay, so hopefully everything is dandy flying there. Gee.
So after a very stressful couple hours, finally at the airport. Flight seems to be on time, so we're gonna do it big.
That's the plane right there. Yeah, that's mine. Oi, it is your boy, GramGreene. We're here at the airport waiting for my flight to board, hopefully soon. Yeah, I'm very excited to go to Vegas. This was a layover, guys. I wasn't even planning on playing any shows. I was gonna go to a techno club tonight, but Space Yacht ended up having a show. And you know me, I already played 2 Space Yachts, so I know the peoples. I made it happen, so. Oh, looks like we are gonna start boarding now. I love you guys, I'll see you very soon. Oi, it is your boy, GramGreene. Yeah, you can see me this time. When I'm making these edits, so much happens in these nights that sometimes I forget very important parts, and after I make the edit, it's already too late, so I decided to do some voice commentary, something different, you know? It's like actually watching a movie, the documentary.
This is so weird.
When I first arrived to Las Vegas, I got into contact with Al Ross, and he asked me one simple question, and he's like, hey, do you want to miss your flight? What do I respond? Well, let's get through this edit first. Hope you guys enjoy it. There will be clips of Al Ross going back to back with Yax, and then of course the back to back with me and Sueldo.
If you don't like Miley Cyrus, fuck you.
This is why I love you.
Space Yacht, how the fuck are we feeling? Alright, who the fuck's ready for SUELDO and GramGreene? Alright, hey, I got one last song, but hey, who the fuck fucks with SpongeBob here? Hey, where the
my leg!
Hey, where the fuck is Ominous at? And we got pizza too, hey! Y'all gotta go.
Who wants to put some fucking cheese and meat in their mouth? Or maybe just cheese. Put your hand up in the sky if you want cheese and or meat inside of your mouth. Hot meat and cheese.
Alright, y'all ready?
Yo, hold up. Las Vegas, make some fucking noise! We got SUELDO and GramGreene coming up, but first,
cheese!
Some pizza. We're gonna bring this shit up front right now. Come on, Friday, you want some pizza? Let's go!
This is our last tune, y'all.
My name is Al Ross, this is Yax. Thank you for fucking with us. This is our last song right here. Who's ready to fuck?
I'm always ready. Not always, but sometimes. Get in here.
I'm serious. Who likes SpongeBob? Come on! OG! Ooh, ooh, ooh! I'm coming right now, one, two, three, let's go!
Let me hear you make some noise.
If you like GramGreene and SUELDO on a Wednesday, make some fucking noise. If you like Al Ross and Yax on a Wednesday, be quiet, please. I'm sorry, make some noise!
Oi, oi, oi. My name is GramGreene, this is my nephew SUELDO. We're gonna fuck it up. Let's get it. If it's nice, we play it twice.
If it's nice, we play it twice, y'all.
For those of y'all who don't know,
GramGreene is one of the riddim OGs.
He's the one who showed us what riddim chopping was in video form. And SUELDO right here is an OG from LA, riddim family. All day, ready? Let's go! Jump it out! Thank you.
Hop in. I was waiting for you.
How are you, man?
How are you feeling from that? It kind of jumped. Nope, wrong way. Oh, even the worst way.
I feel like I'm in 2017, guys. Fucking hell. Ahoy, it is your boy GramGreene. We're out here in Vegas for a couple more hours and then we're gonna head off to Los Angeles. I kinda missed my flight purposely because fuck it. And yeah, so we're gonna continue this last track for 2019. I'm very excited to play LA. Thank you guys, everyone who came out to Vegas, Space Yacht. Last one of 2019 was fucking lit. And yeah, had a best time ever. Love you guys, always. Cheers. Special shout out to Al Ross, who did a lot of the video work. Actually, all of the GramCam footage is from Al Ross. Thank you so much for being a mega supporter. I love you, and I have so much more in store for both of us in the future. Another special shout out to DLK Media, who did some video work for me and SUELDO. Fucking killed it. If you're out in the area, make sure to book him. Another massive shout out to Yax, Algo, Ominous, Blankface, all the homies that were there that night. That showed me all the love and support, as always. And y'all killed it that night. Seriously, it was a nutty night. Sold out Ting. Another one for the GramGreene books. So I had the option of getting an autonomous Lyft when I was going to Al Ross's hotel, meaning that this Lyft would navigate itself, or a self-driving vehicle. This is a prototype that they have in Vegas, so I definitely wanted to try it out. And it was actually cheaper than normal Lyfts. Obviously, there's two guys in the car. You can't really see them because they told me not to videotape anything. But this is something in the future, and they were explaining everything to me, and it's a pretty cool idea. This car was driving itself. Pretty much, and like in a year or so, this should be a thing. Pretty fucking spicy edit, right? So you made it to the end of another GramGreene GramCam extended edit, and this time it was of me going back to back with my sobrino SUELDO at Space Yacht Las Vegas back in December of 2019. Such an amazing time. I gotta thank a lot of people for this night, especially the people at Space Yacht. Henry, who actually got to get a little one-on-one time with him. He is one of the co-founders of Space Yacht. I was listening to his story, seeing how he started off and the magnitude to where Space Yacht is at, where he's going worldwide, throwing shows everywhere. It's something that's very inspiring for me. And if you guys have seen the previous edits of me, you know, raising the $700 in New York to make that night happen. That was really like a catalyst for me to start throwing shows. And then later on, I meet up with Henry and get to talk to him and get even more motivated and determined to do it. And then we fast forward a little more where I throw my first show in Montreal. See how it all like just like boop, 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 all connects in. After the show, we went to the Palm Springs penthouse suite, Fed Banger. He had a suite available for us to go party and it was great. Afterwards, I go back to my hotel at the MGM Grand. Had an amazing time there. It was fucking surreal to be in Las Vegas. It was the first time I ever been there. And afterwards, I met up with Al Ross. So you guys are thinking, okay, I'm doing all this stuff. I had a flight at 9 in the morning. What the fuck happened to the flight, right? 3 a.m., penthouse suite. Al comes up to me and he's like, hey bro, what did you decide? I'm like, okay, if I miss my flight, how am I getting to LA? Because that's the final destination. He's like, well, I have people driving me. My homie Fed Banger is gonna give me a ride. He can give you a ride as well. And I'm like, okay, let's do it. So, decided to miss a flight. But this was a responsible, this was like, I chose to miss this flight. It wasn't because I overslept or anything. And I also had a hotel that I got, and it was really nice. It was at the MGM Grand, so like, I wanted to sleep in it. So, fuck it, I did it. Next morning, wake up, meet up with Al, and then we meet up with Fed Banger. We get into his car, we're his nice, fluffy little dog. He was so big, we were taking turns, putting him on our laps and everything. And pretty much we traveled from Las Vegas all the way to Los Angeles. Took about like 8 hours. We stopped at Route 66. I've always wanted to see that. We out here road tripping. You know what I mean? We got the guy Fed Banger. And is it a cutie? We out here. California 66 was good. Let's go, man! Got some in and out, continued on to LA, dropped Al off, and then made it to my final destination. Finally made it. after all this time to meet up with Jack Rampage, someone that I would be going back to back with the next day. And we meet at his Airbnb, smoke some weed in a jacuzzi, and yeah, that was the first part of this voyage. Next part would be me playing Earthquake Weather back to back with him, and that footage is super spicy. We got footage of that and also of the young Lord Sizzy, so keep it locked for that. Thank you once again for everyone who tuned in to this video and everyone who participated in that night, all the GramFam members that I met. You guys are so kind. Crazy fucking time, guys. Thank you so much for giving me the support and allowing me to do these epic things in my life. Super mega shout out to my pollos hermanos, Diego and Jello, aka Sueldo. These people have been looking after me for so long and they really are family to me. So thank you so much for giving me this opportunity. It really, I love you guys. Hey guys, trust in the universe, because sometimes fucking layovers can be worth it. A 10-hour layover turned out to be one of the best bookings that I've had in 2019. And honestly, one of the best adventures I've had too. It was very refreshing being with my friend Al, Fedbanger, so many others. It was just... I'll talk to you guys soon, and cheer!
See if we can light it up. Yeah, do it. A valiant idea. So then why would they add the matches?
Like, did you go off on the road?
Like, why would they add the matches? I don't get it. Like, alright, well, oh, dude, that was some pretty crazy shit.
I don't know what I just did.
Dude, what the fuck did you just do? I didn't even know that was possible. Amazing. We out here in the studio city, Los Angeles. We got Jack Rampage.
You got it.
In and out, in and out.